Hey everyone, my name is Jonathan Dormish from IGN and I am joined by Tom Marks.
Hello.
And we're here to talk about Persona 5, specifically Persona 5 Scramble, and how it kind of looks like it's basically Persona 5-2,
yeah.
But just not called that. So recently you and I have been talking about the most recent trailer, the recent Japanese trailer for Persona 5 Scramble, as well as the demo for the game, which is available on the Japanese Nintendo Switch eShop, not in America yet. There's no official Western release date for this game yet.
Right.
But from all the evidence that we've been seeing recently, this feels like it is a much more direct Persona 5 sequel than I think we were expecting. We were sort of anticipating a just kind of spin-off fun thing.
Yeah, and the Persona series is known for spin-offs, and I know a lot of people kind of saw this coming a little bit more than us, maybe.
We never saw it coming.
Oh, man. We had to do it once, I guess.
We did, yeah.
But, you know, Persona games do this. They do things where it's like, oh, this is after the events of the main game, and it's a spin-off, and I think that's what a lot of people thought this was. But yeah, now we're getting more and more indication that it's not just a fun spin-off, this is essentially a two, right?
Yes.
This is P5-2, to the point where, in the new Japanese trailer, which you were talking about, Joker at one point holds up a calling card that says Volume 2 on it, which is like, oh, that's pretty direct. And then at the end of the trailer, they show the P5S logo, and it goes P5, and a 2 pops up, and then gets knocked out of the way by an S instead. So that's like, as clear as it can be that this
yeah.
is basically P5-2 in all but name.
And obviously we don't know why they can't just call it Persona 5-2.
Right.
Granted, that naming scheme is kind of silly, so maybe that might be part of it, but we don't know if there are any sort of restrictions, because as of right now, Persona 5 itself is just on PS4, whereas Scramble will both be on PS4 and Nintendo Switch.
It could also be that, you know, the mechanics are so different in this one. It's not a turn-based RPG, but what people are realizing now that the demo is out, now that there's more of this, and we're getting closer to the Japanese release on February 20th, is that a lot of people assumed this was something like Hyrule Warriors or Fire Emblem Warriors, where it's a Musou game that's styled like Persona.
Yeah.
And what we're now realizing is that it's kind of the flip. It's a Persona 5 game where the combat just happens to be Musou. So the demo, which I have played through, picks up essentially right after the story of P5 ends. It's a few months later, and I won't spoil
yeah,
it if
we'll
you haven't finished
free.
P5, but it's as much of a direct sequel as you could imagine,
yeah.
essentially. It picks up, it directly references the events of the next game. It picks up continuing the story, like, almost seamlessly, right? Except for this time gap. And then marches on its merry way from there. So the fact that it's got this day, you know, this day system from P5, it's got the story continuing, it's got trailers where it's literally putting P5-2 for a moment on screen. This is much more of a proper Persona game than I think a lot of people were expecting.
Yeah, especially given sort of what happened with Persona 4, which I think has sort of been the, like, obviously the Persona franchise had its fans before 4, but 4 was sort of this like crystallization moment where it started to break big. And with Persona 4, it became Persona 4 Golden, then we had things like Persona 4 Arena and other spin-offs. So I think we were all sort of thinking, oh, Scramble will just be this fun beat-em-up Musou action game.
Right.
And then we'll move on from there. It'll have some silly ties and connections, but nothing too big. And yeah.
There's Persona dancing games,
exactly.
Why can't there be a Persona Musou?
Exactly, but this seems to be indicating that we are getting a continuation, which is great, because obviously Persona 5 is so driven by its story and by its characters and their development through that very long RPG, so the chance to continue with them is a really exciting opportunity.
Yeah, it's very cool. I just want a Western release date.
Yeah.
Who knows when it'll arrive.
And I'm really curious to see how the new content from Persona 5 Royal either is or isn't integrated into this game.
Yeah, but it's interesting, at least in the demo we played so far, you know, like the new character from Persona 5 Royal who's being added, Kasumi, is not there.
Yeah.
So maybe they're just ignoring some of that stuff. Maybe they're just leaving it ambiguous.
She moved to Canada and
yeah.
is now going to school there.
Sure,
yeah,
sure.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Just like my girlfriend in high school. But yeah, it's interesting to see that they are continuing with the franchise. I think they sort of realized how much people fell in love with these characters and
yeah.
their story. And it's really exciting that even if it's not called Persona 5-2, Persona 5 Scramble is basically that.
Yeah.
Tom, thank you so much for talking with me about this. Persona 5 Scramble right now is just dated, as we mentioned, for a Japanese release on February 20th. We'll wait to see what happens in a Western release. Hopefully we find out more soon about that.
It'll probably lag like 6 months behind
yeah.
like Royal is.
The usual Persona way.
Yeah.
But at this point, Morgana would probably be telling us it was a good idea to go to sleep. So thank you so much for watching this video. But of course, for everything else Persona 5 related, you're already in the right place, IGN.